lots of goals. Always something to strive for.
I want to be in the Olympics for Team USA. I want to win a world title for WSL and just become the best surfer I can be and always keep improving. I think that's very important, and most importantly, just have fun. And it's just such a fun sport, and I find so much joy in just surfing, and I love it. One of my main goals was to get Rookie of the Year. I wrote it down. I put it on my wall somewhere I could look at it every day and just reminded myself that it's what I want to do and just to keep working towards it, and I got it. So I think that when you make goals for yourself and you write it down and you can see it every day, it just pushes me even harder to achieve that. I have very little experience with Chopu. I've been there once before, and not gonna lie, it's a very scary wave. It is heavy, it is shallow. You have to be fearless at that wave. That is where fearless comes in, is you need to just put your head down and paddle and pull in. And this last contest was my first time there, and fortunately the waves weren't like very good, but it was great and I learned so much. So I think the more that I get to go back there and practice, it'll really helped me to become more confident out there and just become better in those type of heavy waves. After I left there, I kind of told myself that I want to go back when there's no contest and just learn as much as I can about it to be one of the best girls out there, so that come the Olympics or even next year for the tour, I will have that much more experience and ready to do competition there. I guess in the beginning I was pretty starstruck by Carissa. She was obviously my idol, and we've actually, over this first year, we've become pretty close friends, and we did some fun adventures on tour together. So yeah, it's pretty cool to see how before I like kind of looked up to her, I was like, wow, like it'd be so cool to hang out there one day. And now it happened naturally, and we're really good friends, and we did safaris in South Africa together. So I think that's pretty cool. Growing up, my dad always wanted me to be a powerful surfer. It's something that actually came natural to me, and he was like, oh, it's an amazing natural talent, and you just need to make the most out of it. So he would, growing up in Hawaii, it's very easy to find powerful waves. They're everywhere, so that's pretty cool. And then we also traveled to Indonesia, which we went there every summer, and I swear, I improved so much each time I went. There's nothing really to do there but surf, so I just surfed every day, learned new things, and yeah, it was pretty cool. We always took a family vacation and had an amazing time. My dad, he traveled there long before I was around, but the tsunami that hit there, I don't even know what year it was. One of his young kids that he met when he was there, his house got wiped away, so he helped him and his family rebuild a house. And they still have the house, and my dad kind of took them under their wing, and it's been pretty cool because each time we went back there, they took care of us like family, so it's been pretty special.